Remember the night. Remember the feeling. Remember the magic in our lives. You opened up my eyes to a new.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to episode 9 of Remember the Magic. In this show, we take a deep dive into everything extinct Disney. In today's episode, I will be talking about Disneyland's and the Magic Kingdom's short-lived but well-remembered daytime spectacle, Tiana's Showboat Jubilee. Let's begin! Just a fair warning, this history segment is going to be a bit short and disjointed, because there isn't really a concrete record of the events regarding this show, so I'm basing all this information off about a dozen different blog posts, so if I get something wrong, please leave me a comment telling me, because otherwise I will have literally no clue. Anyway, let's begin the actual history segment. Even though this show's creation is mainly centered around the film that features the princess this show is based on, I'd argue its true beginnings go back to Disneyland Park in 1992, when the nighttime spectacle Fantasmic opened to the public. Now, I'm not going to go into the full history of this show, because I have a whole mini-series dedicated to that, but long story short, this nighttime spectacular was all centered around the rivers of America, and thus a small amphitheater was built in order to handle the crowds. It also made use of a lot of existing technology in the park, such as the two riverboats. Anyway, fast forward 17 years to 2009, when after a long string of massive failures, the Walt Disney Company was returning to its roots by releasing the first hand-drawn animated feature film since 2004's Home on the Range. The Princess and the Frog would be a retelling of the classic Grimm Brothers Frog Prince fairy tale set in 1920s New Orleans, and was also to feature the first black Disney princess. Disney knew that in the age of DreamWorks, returning to hand-drawn animation was quite a risk, so they hedged their bet with an enormous marketing campaign. And on top of the usual TV spots and trailers, they wanted to put some promotions in the parks as well, specifically Disneyland and Walt Disney World. Disney wanted to put on a big spectacle for the occasion, but they were also keenly aware that it would be temporary, so they wanted to avoid retheming the whole attraction, as this had been hit or miss in the past. Eventually, they decided the best way to promote this movie was a Mardi Gras-style stage show, which then begged the question of location. While Disneyland's Fantasyland Theater had been vacant since the closure of Videopolis in 2006, the Magic Kingdom didn't really have a great performing venue where they could put it, with the only true theater per se at the Magic Kingdom being the now-defunct Galaxy Palace Theater in Tomorrowland. Yeah, Tomorrowland. Princesses. The princesses don't belong in Tomorrowland, even current management knows that. So ideas got tossed around, and eventually they realized that every night, the Mark Twain riverboat in Disneyland was turned into a giant three-story stage. Disney also quickly realized that they could make minor enhancements to the Magic Kingdom's Liberty Bell to achieve a remarkably similar experience. With an idea finally agreed upon, work began dreaming up this new show. With the movie's premiere of December 11th, 2009 quickly approaching, Disney announced the new show, now dubbed Tiana's Showboat Jubilee, on October 23rd, 2009. What we were told was that this new show would feature a Mardi Gras-style parade, a jazz band processional, and a revue-style show aboard the boat featuring Randy Newman's music from the film with the obligatory characters. As the opening dates of October 26th in the Magic Kingdom and November 6th in Disneyland Park crept closer and closer, we learned a lot more about this new show. Not only was it to feature some lucky guest who would get to participate in the show becoming part of the ensemble, but it would also be performed 4 times a day at 11:15, 12:45, 2:45, and 4:15. Eventually, the big day came. Well, at least for the Magic Kingdom. Disneyland would have to wait a few more days. Anyway, the big day came for the Magic Kingdom, and oh boy, did this show get one hell of a premiere. On the morning of October 26th, 2009, Disney began celebrating the newest princess in the Disney lineup by starting the day off with her coronation. This one-time-only show featured tons of Disney characters, as well as the performers from Showboat Jubilee. Anyway, this was certainly a spectacular way to introduce the park's latest show, and at 11:15, the show officially premiered. People absolutely loved Tiana's Showboat Jubilee. It was energetic, fun, flashy, and incredibly entertaining. Unfortunately, this offering was only available as a promotion for the movie, and even more unfortunately, unlike other events where they are extended the stay, Disney doubled down on their end date. Tiana's Showboat Jubilee held its final performances on both coasts on January 3rd, 2010, and while fans desperately clung to the threads of evidence pointing to its staying, these rumors were unfortunately incorrect, and the show was never to be seen again. However, even though this show is one of the most short-lived in Disney history, it has one of the biggest fan bases I've ever seen. People absolutely adored this show, and with good reason. Since 2010, fans have been begging Disney to bring it back, but unfortunately there just hasn't been a good enough reason to. Oh, wait a minute! That's right, folks, on June 25th of this year, Disney announced that the controversial Splash Mountain attraction would be getting turned into a Princess and the Frog ride. I'm not gonna go into this here because I don't want a gazillion dislikes on this video, but I'm cautiously optimistic. I just really hope they put money into it, because the last thing this resort needs is Screens Mountain. But even if that unfortunately quite likely scenario happens, to win my 100% affection, Disney needs to do two very simple things. One, make this a reality.
You can blame my friends on the other side.
And two, bring back Showboat Jubilee. And the rumor mill is certainly turning when it comes to this possibility, but at this point, even Splash Mountain's closure isn't yet announced, and it's expected to be a while before it actually closes, so I'd say it's safe to say that Disney has not begun planning the opening festivities for when the attraction finally does open. With all that said, let's move on to the design segment. So this show is incredible, but why? Well, I'm going to answer that by going scene by scene through this marvelous celebration. I'm going to be going off footage from the Magic Kingdom version simply because a greater amount of higher quality footage is available from that. Though the two shows were nearly identical, barring the processional route and the actual vessel. With all that said, let's begin! The show begins as a cavalcade of dancers and characters emerge onto the riverside pathways. They perform a small processional making their way down to the riverboat dock to the tune of Down in New Orleans from the film. They also hand out Mardi Gras beads as they move down the parade route, thankfully not requiring the same incentive as in a traditional Mardi Gras parade. Don't read too much into that. Look it up, kids. Actually, don't. I don't want to get sued. Anyway, as the performers reach the dock, the music comes to an end and transitions into Gonna Take You There as the captain introduces the show. After the boat reaches the main viewing location, just in front of the Country Bear Jamboree, Tiana begins the main show. She then briefly talks to Lewis, discussing how they both reached out for their dreams. This leads immediately into Almost There, which is performed by Tiana as the ensemble provides a colorful spectacle alongside her through the use of some beautiful parasols. After this number ends, Lewis tells Tiana that her sharing her dream has inspired him to share his. Lewis tells everyone that he wants to be human before singing a rendition of When We're Human from the film. Prince Naveen also joins in just like in the movie, which out of context kinda makes no sense. All while the ensemble presents large hand props that look really incredible from afar. As the song concludes, thunder strikes as an explosive goes off on the roof of the boat. Dr. Facilier appears and starts terrorizing the cast. He then announces that he's going to perform some magic before beginning Friends on the Other Side from the film. Facilier then calls forth tarot cards, and for some reason, Prince Naveen dives headfirst into danger, again, at the hands of the evil voodoo master. After this, shadow demons take over the riverboat in the form of these simple yet brilliant cloth and cardboard cutouts on sticks. Then the number ends, and Facilier just kind of awkwardly exits. Tiana then tells the crowd that you can't let evil people like that take away your dreams, and then begins passing along the advice Mama Odie gave her about how to make those dreams come true, and begins to sing my personal favorite song from the movie, Dig a Little Deeper. As they do this, the ensemble presents even more large hand props, and those things you see outside of the used car dealerships that are flapping around appear on the rooftops. Tiana then invites Lewis to do a solo, which he then gracefully performs. After an explosive finish, the main show ends, but this does not mark an end to the performance as a whole, as while the characters bid their farewells, the boat continues to move forward. The riverboats cannot travel in reverse. They once again begin singing Gonna Take You There as they chug along the river, and even though as they round the bend and dip out of sight, the vocals cut out, the instrumental continues playing. As, like most Disney Parks nerds can tell you, that riverboat only has one dock, for the public at least, and that's in Liberty Square. So around 5 to 7 minutes later, the boat can be seen once again. The entire cast on the boat then arrives at the dock, and as they disembark, Lewis provides musical accompaniment. Once everyone is off the boat, the entire cast travels back up the streets of the park to where they started, once again singing Down in New Orleans from the movie. And then the show is over. So yeah, this show can be a bit of a mess at times, but I think it's still easily one of the best shows Disney has ever created. Why, you ask? Well, allow me to explain in the conclusion. So yeah, this show makes literally no sense at times. Why does Lewis still want to be human if he's already in the band at the end of the film? Why does Naveen blindly play into Dr. Facilier's antics when he's been screwed by him before? And probably the most glaring issue, why is Dr. Facilier even alive in the first place? I'm not gonna pretend like these aren't outstanding plot holes, but I am going to ignore them. Why? Because this is a temporary promotional theme park show. Limited time theme park shows made specifically to promote a movie by design make absolutely no sense. They're just greatest hit montages. But be honest, you forgot about that for a second, didn't you? This show did such a good job at promoting this movie that people often look at it as a full-blown stage show rather than a 3-month promotional cavalcade. That is fascinating to me. Personally, I had heard of this show for years, but I'd only started to take a deep dive into it when my friend urged me to do it after the Splash Mountain announcement. To say I was thoroughly impressed was an understatement. I was blown away by this show's spectacle, technical brilliance, and actual content. And when I discovered it, I assumed it was a long-running show at the Magic Kingdom that we lost in the early 2010s for one reason or another. Suffice to say, you could have knocked me over with a feather when I found out it was only a 3-month run. Mainly because of its dedicated fan base and its production value. Seriously, this is OLC levels of investment put into a show that only lasted 3 months. I am a firm believer that Tiana's Showboat Jubilee is the best non-parader spectacular entertainment offering ever to come to the Magic Kingdom. Yes, even including great moments in history. The Magic Kingdom has a lot of very interesting defunct entertainment under its belt. I mean, Dream Along with Mickey, which I'm going to talk about next time, was literally a heartfelt beauty that conveyed a true message to those who saw it. Tiana's Showboat Jubilee did the same, and it did it with some spectacular production value. Anyway, this show is incredible. It's certainly the best entertainment in the Magic Kingdom, and it's absolutely in my top 3 favorite entertainment offerings of all time. And that's kinda all I have to say. I know this was a shorter video, but it was important to me to make it. Other than a fiercely dedicated fan base, very few people remember this show or even knew it existed in the first place, which is a shame because it was truly spectacular. I just really hope they bring this back for whenever that Princess and the Frog Splash Mountain opens, because it's been 10 years now, and I think it's about time to bring back some friends from the other side. Thank you for watching this episode of Remember the Magic. If you enjoyed it, please consider liking the video and maybe even subscribing to my YouTube channel. There are a lot of videos coming out real soon you won't want to miss, so be sure to click the bell icon so you get notified when we upload a new video. And remember, the answers to where we are going often lie in our past. Have a great, big, beautiful day, and remember, tomorrow is just a dream away.